And then notice here we have old value and then we have new value. So if you think about it here for a minute, the old value of 1 on the scale becomes what when we reverse code it? We literally reverse it, so a 1 becomes a 7. Go ahead and click add. And then a 2 becomes a 6. Click add. And 3 becomes a 5. Add. And then this one could be confusing. You may think to yourself, well, wait, a 4 becomes a 4. Okay, let's just leave it blank then. We don't have to do that one. Actually, if you don't do it, SPSS will put missing values or periods in that place. So you want to make sure you go ahead and put this one in as well. So 4 becomes a 4. And then see this pattern here? Our next value is 5. So then 5 becomes a 3. And then a 6 is going to be recoded into a 2. And finally, we have a 7, which will become a 1. Go ahead and click add. And you should see this pattern now here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then the descending order, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you see that, you're in great shape. And I should say as a quick side note, this can be used whether your Likert scale has 7 items, 5 items, or what have you. On a 5-item Likert scale, it would just 1 becomes a 5, 2 becomes a 4, and so on. Hey, go ahead and click continue. And then we're about to click OK. When you do, take a look when we go back here at these two places here to the right of Perfect 4. So click OK. And there we go. Notice we had two new variables created. They should be the reverse coded variables of Perfect 3 and Perfect 4. But let's go ahead and check them to make sure. If our original variable was a 1, the reverse coded variable for Perfect 3 should be a 7, right? Okay, good. You see that there? 1 becomes a 7. Let's try a few more. A 4 should remain a 4. That looks good. A 6 should become a 2. Looks great. Now, for Perfect 4, we have a 1, once again, should be a 7. A 5 should be a 3. And a 7 should be a 1. So that looks perfect. It's exactly what we want. You can do this for as many variables as you want in SPSS. There's really, I don't think you'll run into any limitations there whatsoever. Now, if you want to know how to add up these variables to create a total score, we do cover that in another video, so you might want to take a look at that. But what we would do here, in case you're curious, is add Perfect 1, Perfect 2, and then Perfect 3 underscore R, and Perfect 4 underscore R. And we wouldn't work with these two because they were the negative items that had not yet been reverse coded. So you would literally, for person 1, they'd have 6 plus 6 plus 7 plus 6, or 12, 19, and 6 is 25. So that would be person 1's total score. And as I said earlier, we can do that in SPSS. It's pretty simple to do. Okay, this concludes the video on reverse coding Likert items in SPSS.